counts. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now, from the Sunbury Motor Studio, here's Steve Jones.
Yes, today's show brought to you by Purdy Insurance. Market Street in Sunbury, go to purdyinsurance.com. Auto, home, life, business, motorcycle, boat. Whatever your insurance needs are, they'll take care of your Purdy Insurance. And they'll do everything they can to save you money. Huge. Huge. And the Purdy Memorial Golf Tournament, once again, taking place this time of the, again, at the Susquehanna Valley Country Club. This will be, what, my 10th appearance there? Doing it? Matt, you've been in the last, what, three or four?
This will be my... Also be my second as producer, but I've been to three. This will be my third I've attended.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. And then... And it's such a great cause, the Greater Susquehanna Valley YMCA. They do so much for the community, and Bonnie and her group do great work. And, of course, this is the Truman H. Purdy Memorial Golf Tournament. So Adam's grandfather. So there's a depth of meaning there. It's going to start at 10 Wednesday. I look forward to it every year. To me, it is, I block out everything on my calendar to do it. I block out everything on my calendar to do it because it means that much to me. It means that much to be there. It'll be great to see Tom Mertz there. It's going to be great to see Corey from Brewers Outlet there. But it's been great to see all of you there. You know, Mark Lawrence always stops by, and, you know, Mark and I always, you know, have a great time together. Dave Ritchie, you cannot say enough good things about Dave. I will also be there. And what? No.
S-U-I-T. That spells suit. Da.
Maybe Doug will stop by. Maybe we'll get Doug Birdsong to stop by. So.
Oh, my almighty!
I mean, that'd be fun if Doug stopped by, wouldn't it?
I would love to have him stop by.
Dougie. You got to stop by. We're going to do the show live. Now, isn't it great when we sit out in the patio area and we're doing the show? And you look out, the first tee is to the right, cascading down the hill. The ninth hole, the green, is right in front of us. So we can see the golf course in front of us. But then as we look out over the valley and up to the mountain range, how beautiful is that?
Oh, it's a tremendous scene. And when and I said at the top of the show, Wednesday's weather is going to be perfect.
Unreal. It's going to be great. It is going to be great on Wednesday. And I can't wait to be there. Cannot wait. For an awesome cause with great people. Adam Purdy is second to none. Steve Engel, second to none. I mean, just great people. Looking forward to it very much. That's on Wednesday. All right. And we're all, and I mentioned Tom Mertz. We're in the Sunbury Motors studio. Sunbury Motors. 4th Street in Sunbury, Sunbury Motors, Kia, Routes 11 to 15, Hummel's Wharf, online at sunburymotors.com. Time now for our play-by-play call of the day. Anthony Rizzo, instant impact for the Yankees. Maybe not as great an impact as I thought.
Line drive, a base hit to left field, and that'll tie the score. Gardner comes home. It's a 1-1 game. And Rizzo's first weekend as a Yankee continues to glimmer.
What a thrill for Michael Kay to broadcast a professionals games. All right.
Hey, we love him. That's all that matters. He's ours now.
Yeah. You didn't love him last week. You hated him. I did that one time with a with a player. In fact, there was a player this year I did it with too. Cy Kerber, catcher. Great guy. I like Cy a lot personally. He had played with Trenton and Frederick before he came here, and he explained to me how he came back, you know, and that essentially, he's not from Chicago. He said, well, you can play at State College the rest of the season. He goes, I'll play there. I love that place. Right? I made the comment about him, and then there was a guy years ago that the Indians and the Cardinals made a trade. So he'd been playing for Mahoning Valley, now suddenly he's playing for State College. And I said, you know, a week ago, I said, the fans here just were not exactly enamored with him. I said, now they love him. They have embraced him as one of their own. That's your Rizzo trade. Rizzo, Cubs, acquire him. Couple hits. I love Rizzo.
But I always loved him. I always thought he was a good player. I just thought he was going to go to the Red Sox.
I'm going to buy a jersey.
Well, see, I have to wait on that because, A, I've been on a bad luck streak with getting jerseys or jerseys lately. And second of all, I got to make sure that he's re-signed, which the Yankees should do, past this year.
You're not going to put little Luke in one of a Rizzo jersey, are you?
If he's there long term, I may have to. I mean, my dad literally just got him a Tanaka jersey, and then he goes over to Japan. He's already got an outdated jersey, and he's only worn it this his first season, as you know.
Mm-hmm. But he was wearing the Tanaka jersey when he came over my house.
That's right. Yeah, there was a certain theme when we came over.
Yeah, I know. You're all wearing Yankee stuff, you know, and then Lisa, as usual, is dressed as pure class. Thought I'd mention that. And Lisa, by the way, could wear a Yankee jersey, and I would still say pure class.
That's no surprise.
Okay. All right.
I tried, but she refused.
Some people can get away with it. I saw the Yankee garb that was on, you know, and I saw it all. You're all wearing it. You know, I said, little Luke looked adorable. Okay. I thought it was very complimentary, the lad.
You were.
So, all right. Is the suit having trouble finding Olympic events on TV?
He hasn't mentioned. I just know that he just did confirm in our PD meeting this morning that he has been glued and watching everything.
So he's the one.
So my guess is he probably has Peacock and is watching everything else, yeah.
So based on the ratings, he's the one. He's the guy.
Actually, I guarantee you he has been, because I just think of all of the Bucknell Road games where he's watching College Game Day on his iPad when we're driving to the Bucknell game.
Oh, boy.
Which is fine. It gave us some entertainment during the ride down, but I'm just pointing that out.
Oh, boy. Please tell me that Doug's driving.
Okay, that's how it's going this year. Okay.
Well, no, I'm just saying, I don't want the suit watching game day driving.
Oh, yeah, no, it's when Doug's driving. Yes, yes.
That's my point.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I wouldn't put it past you-know-who to... I got the stream over here. Hey, this is great. I got one hand on the wheel. We're good. Oh, jeez. What could possibly happen? Oh, I don't know. Think of the possibility. All right. So what does name, image, and likeness mean? As I mentioned before, near the top of the show, I can't get into the name until he actually is, like, on the campus, I guess. But the guy that it verbaled to Ohio State, quarterback, wants to reclassify and join the team now, which then gives him an opportunity to make name, image, and likeness money, which they claim could be near the neighborhood of seven figures. Cannot evidently do it as a high school student in the state of Texas based on their laws. I only know the basics of some of these state laws, so I have no idea. I'm not going to sit there and pretend I'm an expert on what the Texas law says. I know there are basics in there that match up with everybody else. But evidently, as a high school student, he can't make NIL money. As a college student, he can, so he wants to reclassify. Welcome to another phase of the new world. That is the way it has been. And, you know, it's this is the way it's going to be. You're going to see individuals attempting to reclassify. And that's, you know, what's interesting about this is obviously he'll get started earlier. He can get name, image, and likeness. But he's not the first one. I'll give you an example. Moochie Johnson had been a high school player in Cleveland. And he was able to reclassify and enroll for the second half of the season, starting with the, quote, spring semester. So he played, he didn't play a ton. I would say Moochie Johnson would play maybe 6 to 8 minutes a game, but he was playing on the Ohio State basketball team because he was able to get into school earlier. Okay. So you have a lot of people that enter in the spring semester anyway. Football players enter in the spring semester. Well, basketball players can too, and he did. So it's not unprecedented. About guys, you know, and there are a lot of guys that are reclassifying because they want to get into school earlier and get their college clock going, and name, image, and likeness is going to increase their desire to get the clock rolling as quickly as possible. It's the world we're in right now. It's the world we're in. And some parts are really good, and other parts are like, there's some parts I think are really good, and there's some parts where I have a wait-and-see attitude. As I've said a million times, some new ideas are great ideas. Not every new idea is a great idea. And not every old idea is outdated. Some old ideas are tried and true and rock solid for a reason. We just have to go forward and figure out which one is which. We'll come back with more in a moment. Great to have you with us today. Can't wait to be at the Susquehanna Valley Country Club on Wednesday. We're going to be up on the, shall we call it the veranda?
Yeah, sure.
It sounds classy.
Definitely.
I mean, it beats how the suit describes it, that place outside. Here on News Radio 1070 WKOK. On the show today. Hope you can come out and see us on Wednesday at the Susquehanna Valley Country Club for the Purdy Memorial Golf Tournament to benefit the Greater Susquehanna Valley YMCA. Great event. Starts at 10. I think, Maddie, I'm going to get out there. I'm going to try and get out there about 9:15 or so. Get rolling. Get there early enough and go from there. You'll hit a few balls, maybe. And to quote the suit, you know, like, why don't you warm up? He says, I don't need no stinking practice. I'm like, oh, geez. He scares me. And others on the course.
Get the lingerie on the deck. Call the janitor.
But we'll go out and have a good time. Matt's all warmed up, set to go.
Yeah, I even got a couple pars yesterday.
Well done.
Yeah.
Nice job. Nice job. Well, I'm supposed to be playing golf with Jack this week. So he called me the other day and he says, yeah, I'm all warmed up. I said, great. I said, he says, guess where I warmed up? Well, of course, it's always someplace great. So there have been times where he's called me and he'll say, guess where I am? Oh, how the heck am I supposed to know? He'll say, I'm at Whistling Straits. Guess where I am? I'm at Pebble Beach. Guess where I am? I'm at Pinehurst. So he says to me, guess where I warmed up? I said, I don't know, Augusta National. He goes, no. The Greenbrier. I said, the Greenbrier. I said, was one of the co-owners there? He goes, nope, he wasn't there. One of the co-owners is Phil Mickelson of the Greenbrier. So, there you go. He's all set to go. I asked the suit where he warmed up. He said, Wally's World of Golf Fun. I said, what? I said, what? What is that? It's a miniature golf course. Where'd you warm up? Pirates Cove. Great, really. I'm putting really well. And I've told you about the Dick Girardi story, right?
I think so, yeah.
Where Dick only, when Dick plays in charity golf tournaments, he only brings a 7-iron and a putter. He only chips and putts. Maybe he'll tee off on a par 3. And Dick is a fabulous putter. Of the three of us, like Jack and I are better than Dick is in a lot of the other phases of the game, right? But Dick, as a putter, is probably better than either one of us. His putter, he was down playing mini golf in Towson, Maryland. And he goes out. What's usually mini golf par, like 36? Like to a hole, right? 36?
Usually, I think, yeah.
Dick shoots a 27.
That's amazing. Now that's amazing.
20. No, Dick's a great putter.
Wow.
So Dick walks up to the guy in the stand. He says, I love this putter. I want it. $20. Slams it down. He goes, the guy says, it's yours. That's the one he's had ever since.
You, sir, are my hero.
He putts with a mini golf putter.
That's the first time I've heard that one, but hey, whatever works.
But, I mean, they're all like standard, like, you know, the two-edge blade, you know. So it's not like one of those Scotty Cameron, like, ooh, oh, Scotty Cameron, wow, where the head cover is worth like $90. Yeah. And he goes down, he says, I love this putter. How much, guy? $20. Boom, got it, yours. Now that's how you make things work. And he'll be on teams and he'll say, like, he'll play with Bill Olsey, and Olsey will come up to me and he'll say, Steve, he says, it's unbelievable. He says, we get to the green, we tell him which direction it's going, bang, knocks it in. He said, he got like 6 birdies. And, you know, because the coaches versus cancer tournament's the 27th of August. But my goodness, that was phenomenal. Phenomenal. I love this tournament, though. Love the layout. I've always enjoyed the Susquehanna Valley Country Club. Even the third hole, which is a pain in the you-know-what. Oh, that's as tough a par 3 as I've ever played in my life. The one that's down the hill over the creek. Remember last year, I think I hit a 7-iron, and I hit that thing right on the money, and I play a left-to-right draw. And remember what happened? There's that one stinking tree over there on the left side of the green, and
oh,
I hit it.
Oh, yes. That was right.
Like, I hit it, I thought, oh, this is gonna be great. It's exactly what I need, because
yep.
The draw plays into the contour of the green. Like, this is a... Oh, jeez. Anybody have a wedge? I need it. Guess that didn't work out so well. I mean, we ended up parring the hole. When it comes to car buying, there's the other guy's way, and then there's the FMC way. The other guys force you into a vehicle you really don't want. The Sunbury Motors way lets you take the time you need to browse, ask questions, and take the test drive and think on it. For over 100 years, the Merce family and all their employees have made your experience the most pleasant one you'll ever have. The other guys won't offer you the best price for your trade, no matter how much they say they will. The FMC way is their promise to provide you with the most money the market shows your vehicle is worth. The FMC way is to offer you all applicable factory rebates on new vehicles and generous discounts. Looking for a pre-owned vehicle? The FMC way checks each vehicle in a 200-mile radius to determine the lowest price, then beat it. It's the lowest price promise, just part of the FMC way. The choice is up to you, the other guy's way or the FMC way. The FMC way wins every time. Sunbury Motors Company in the North 4th Street Auto Plaza, Sunbury, and at sunburymotors.com. Selling more cars and satisfying more customers for over 100 years.
Taking your calls at 800-795-9565. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now, from the Sunbury Motor Studio, here's Steve Jones.
Today's show brought to you by Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. Auto, home, life, business, boat, motorcycle, you name it, they have it. They want to make sure you're fully insured. They also want to make sure that they do everything they can to save you money. That's critical. And that is critical. It's part of their mission. Do whatever they can to save you money. And that's Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. And, of course, the Purdy Memorial Golf Tournament is Wednesday. We're excited to be there. We'll be out, as the suit would say, that area outside. I suppose that when growing up in Benton, that was how they described it.
Get the lingerie on the deck. Call the janitor.
Oh, my goodness. He just turned 50, by the way. I suppose that came up in the staff meeting.
Actually, it didn't, surprisingly. We just welcomed him back from his week off, and that was it.
Took a week off, did he?
He did. I guess he does that every year.
Who was more relaxed, you or the staff? Him or the staff?
That's a good question.
Boy, you guys all look relaxed. There's a reason, Ace. All right. And by the way, I know obviously there's a lot of COVID stories going on like right now. Did you see that among people who are 65 or older, Pennsylvania is number one in the nation at 65 and over having at least one dose of the vaccine, and is series complete, the national number for any 65 and older. The nation's 90%. Pennsylvania's above that. Having at least one dose. 80.1% have a complete series. Okay? And Pennsylvania's 84%. Pretty good, huh? Well done. Well done. All right, so you're all happy about the Yankees.
I am, yes. And with the way the schedule is, they better keep rolling and taking advantage.
Oh, no, I mean, the schedule. I mean, my goodness. I mean, the Spikes could win some games. I mean, this might actually help Cole's ERA against legitimate opponents he has struggled. No? That's not what you're saying?
I'm just saying they're the better team and they should take advantage.
I mean he's going to win some games now, finally. All right. Better call him back after the show. That's the hammer. That's what that was. That was Jack. All right. So, we talked about the Olympics earlier. Media day, by the way, for football here is Saturday. Of course, there'll be a lot of rules surrounding it, which is fine. I mean, it's the way it has to be right now. And, of course, camp actually gets going in earnest on Friday. Question is going to be, it'll be interesting to see how they've planned it out, because you can get into patterns as how to do things, but the rules keep changing the patterns. So the rule this year is that there will be fewer contact days. Now, remember when the original proposal came out? And I think this is one of those, somebody was floating something and it didn't work out. Right. They were proposing 8 contact days or something like that. I was like, 8? I said, are you kidding me? You can't get ready for a season with 8 contact days. And then they settled on, 18 was the number. So you're going to have to work around more contact days. I mean, fewer contact days, which is okay, because a lot of coaches have been smart about it. There's a balance between contact and at some point making sure that you have enough legs to play the opener. And Penn State's opener is with Wisconsin. So you want to make sure that you have a proper balance of that anyway. Anyway, you want to make sure you have that, because you want to, don't want to work, and all of a sudden you get to the end of camp and in the heat, and it's going to be hot this weekend just to start out. It's going to be 86 to 88 this weekend. Well, it's the month of August. It's going to happen. You're like, oh, man, I'm dragging. You don't want your team in mud. So you do tailor your hitting in such a way where you start tapering at the right time anyway. So there's not as much hitting in preseason as everybody believes there is. Oh, there's hitting, and you have to hit. But not as much as people think. Everybody thinks you're out there belting each other for hours every single day. Nope. There are some days where, hey, look, it's a lighter day. It is a walkthrough type of day, or it's a half-speed day, or it's, shorts and shells. You know, you're wearing helmets all the time, but shorts and shells, that happens all the time. I think there's a lot of misperception about there's misperception about, I think people think that people are sneaking in extra hitting practices and things. That's, you can't do, the reason you can't do that is it's not smart. It's not smart to do that. You have to hit. There's no getting, you have to. But this is where the sports performance part comes into play. The sports performance part comes into play in the ability of a coach . So, by the way, I know what the issue is, by the way. Why Jack called.
Oh, is it for tomorrow?
Yes. Our fourth tested positive.
Ah.
So they're working on another fourth. Something about some guy named Morikawa. I don't know.
Hey, now that would be sensational.
Actually, his picture is up at the course. Because he's won at Sunny Hannah before.
Okay, well, then there you go.
Oh, you should see the clubhouse there. You go into the clubhouse there? The pictures of all the people that played there? How many times they played there? Like, Tigers played, I don't know, two or three times there. Mickelson's played there two or three times. And you look at the champions that have gone through there that have played. So right now the big picture is Morikawa. So they're working on a fourth. Now, the last time we needed a fourth, it was Mike Wagner. But Mike won't be able to play this time.
Now, if you get him, you should recruit him to come Wednesday for the Purdy tourney.
I know.
To come school us all.
What, Morikawa?
Yes.
We got this guy, Morikawa. Why don't you come on with the Purdy tournament? The people of the Susquehanna Valley Country Club would fall down.
What?
The PGA and British Open champion?
Yeah, right? They totally would.
Except for one person. Who's this guy?
S-U-I-T. That spells Suta.
Did he play at Chickalimmy?
No good! No good! No good!
It just is the saddest commentary. All right, so... It's so sad. Well, Tigers Hero World Challenge set to return. That's good. Yeah, that's good. Xander Schauffele won the gold medal in Japan in golf. So he'll have one more gold medal than the U.S. women's soccer team. Okay. What?
Get the lingerie on the deck. Call the janitor.
That was always the joke. That was always the joke I had about the U.S. men's basketball team in Athens. Cale Sanderson had won more gold medal than they did combined. So, like, okay, you know, that, yeah, I mean, people don't realize the U.S. did not win the gold in Rio either, women's soccer.
That's correct. They were actually knocked down in the quarterfinals, I believe.
And, well. Canada beat them. Canada, they had not lost to Canada in 20 years. And I know you're saying it's a controversial call. You shouldn't be in that position. The U.S. women's soccer team is head and shoulders above everybody. They should not be in that position. Yeah, some days you don't have it. This is the second time in the tournament they didn't have it. They didn't have it at the right time, at the wrong time.
Now, from what I saw, there were some injuries, including Alyssa Nair, who wasn't in goal for the PK. Yeah, but
yeah, Nair was not in goal. Yeah, she got hurt. I did know that. And of course, Erica Dombach's one of the coaches. So I guess now they play for the bronze.
That'll be Thursday at 4 a.m. against Australia, and then it's Sweden and Canada for the gold on Saturday.
I always love when I hear, and X won the silver. Like, you don't win the silver, you get the silver. No offense, you win the gold, okay? In the silver, you finished in second place, you get it. You didn't win it. Unless you're in a match. Now, for example, if the U.S. women's soccer team wins the matchup, and who are they playing against?
Australia.
They beat Australia. They will win the bronze because they had to win the game to get the bronze. So, yeah, you technically would win the bronze. But yeah, and they won the bronze medal. No, well, you finished third. So you got one, okay? Maybe it's a technical thing, but always, and wins the silver and wins bronze. No, you get silver, you get bronze, right? Okay, the person that won gold won. Okay, you didn't win. The Tampa Bay Rays win the silver. Nope. the Montreal Canadiens win the... Nope. The Phoenix Suns win... Nope. The Kansas City... Nope. Now, this it just sounds anti-Olympics. I know it does. But tell me I'm wrong.
That's absolutely right.
I mean, you get it, which is a great honor. Which means you're second among all the people that ever competed. But there's only one winner that wins the gold. They won it. They won it. You get your second place. Okay? And that's not anti-whatever. It's just a fact of life. I've always found the terminology to be interesting. All right. It's going to be great to be with everybody on Wednesday. Looking forward to it. Looking forward to it. This will be great. Get the whole gang back together again. Out on the patio. Watch everybody sweat bullets out until everything's actually on the air. I always find that to be entertaining.
Well, actually, because last year we cut it close. We're going to make sure we're going to get everything done before we golf. At least that's our plan, me and the suit.
Really?
Yes.
So you'll be doing it?
Oh, my almighty!
I'm a supervisor. Back with more in a moment. We'll wrap it up, brought to you by Purdy Insurance on News Radio 1070 WKOK.
Possible. Possible. It depends if you decide. If you go decide on...
Last time I saw that, it was the fourth quarter of a Shikellamy-Danville football game. Fans didn't have the same reaction.
What?
You're going to declare what? No.
Oh, my almighty.
All right. So, did you see the Facebook post that Roger put out today?
I have not yet, no.
Oh, come on. Mertzi also is on her site, too. It is Aaron Rodgers with both his hands in the air like touchdown, with the back of his hands facing us. So the left pinky finger, and it says, choked 15 in one season. The left ring finger says Colin Kaepernick. The middle finger has the Super Bowl ring and says, beat Caleb Haney in NFC Championship game. The index finger is home loss to the 49ers, thumb nothing. Okay. Now they get over to the right hand, the pinky. Let's go left to right. So the thumb, choked versus Seahawks. Index finger, outplayed by Carson Palmer. Middle finger, destroyed by Falcons. Ring finger, destroyed by 49ers. Pinky, Kevin King.
You, sir, are my hero.
That's amazing.
Roger's the one to put it out. I don't know where Roger found it, but it was a riot. That didn't. I mean, Mercy didn't just love it. She hit you full throated like laughter. Hey, you want to keep putting yourself out there and and acting like you're complaining about stuff and things like that? You're gonna get people that are gonna sit there and say, "Hey, excuse me, like you've done a lot of great things, but." You are going to have people that look at your resume and say, well, okay, winning once is difficult enough. We all know that. Okay? Simone Biles, by the way, will compete in the, on the balance beam. Not easy, but, I mean, none of this stuff's easy. Boy, I'd love to see her go out and win the gold and just, you know what I mean? Just be her. How about that?
Totally.
Just go out, be her. I'd love to see it. And it's great the way Jade Carey stepped up. Won the gold. I do enjoy the fact, and I didn't see either performance, so I'm not going to comment on the performances because I didn't see either one. But the fact that one stepped up and won the all-around, Suni Lee, and Jade Carey won the floor exercise. When they were there and they competed, they took advantage of the opportunity and they won gold. I think that's really, really cool. It's great. It really is. I think that's great. And Simone Biles will go in the on the balance beam. I actually did an opening once for TV on a balance beam. Ever tell you that?
No, I need to see this.
Oh, no. It's 4 inches wide. I had to walk. I had to walk in the balance beam while looking at the camera. Did the thing. I mean, you want to talk about, like, there's no way I'm doing this twice. I did it in one take.
That's good work by you.
One take. I said, how was that? They go, that was great. I said, we're done, right? Yeah. I said, So then I had to do an opening on a platform, 10-meter platform. And it was the next one. I was doing swimming and diving. And I walked to the end, and I'm doing the opening. Says, and I looked at the camera, and I said, the crew saw me on the balance beam, and I never jumped off. I said, they're daring me to dive in the pool. They don't think I'll do it. So I put the mic down, I stepped back, then I ran to the edge, I stopped. We then put the jacket and tie on an actual diver who went up and did this 2.5 twist, went into the water, boom, they show him going in the water, boom, he comes out, I put the suit back on, I then dive into the water, and then I come up and I say, swimming and diving, I said, I told you I'd do it, swimming and diving is next.
For nearly 100 years, Purdy Insurance has been your locally owned, family-operated source for insurance products. With a staff of over 20 and partnerships with some of the industry's most trusted companies, Purdy has the experience and resources to get the job done. Whether you need personal, home, and auto, or complex business insurance solutions, Purdy will help you navigate through the process. Call today at 570-286-5855, or better yet, stop in their Sunbury office to see what Purdy Insurance can do for you.
When it comes to car buying, there's the other guy's way, and then there's the SMC way. The other guys force you into a vehicle you really don't want. The Sunbury Motors way lets you take the time you need to browse, ask questions, and take the test drive and think on it. For over 100 years, the Mertz family and all their employees have made your experience the most pleasant one you'll ever have. The other guys won't offer you the best price for your trade, no matter how much they say they will. The SMC way is their promise to provide you with the most money the market shows your vehicle is worth. The SMC way is to offer you all applicable factory rebates on new vehicles and generous discounts. Looking for a pre-owned vehicle? The SMC way checks each vehicle in a 200-mile radius to determine the lowest price, then beat it. It's the lowest price promise, just part of the SMC way. The choice is up to you, the other guy's way or the SMC way. The SMC way wins every time. Sunbury Motors Company in the North 4th Street Auto Plaza, Sunbury, and at sunburymotors.com. Selling more cars and satisfying more customers for over 100 years.